Hello, Late But Great. This is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So Michelle picked the topic of the week, and I am going to read it to you. An anonymous viewer wrote into the channel with a heartbreaking story about being sexually abused when younger by someone of the same gender. This person identified as asexual for a long time, but now is questioning that, but is reluctant to explore their identity because of their past. Do you feel there is a link between what happens to us while we were growing up and how we ultimately identify as adults? What advice would you have for someone trying to overcome the traumas of their childhood? Well, I am a firm believer that sexual orientation and gender identity is inherent. It's genetic. As a matter of fact, I was just reading an article on Yahoo News on the internet about a university in Illinois that actually found a big difference between gay men and homosexual men and heterosexual men genetically. They did a study where they had like 1,000 gay men and compared their genes. It was especially in the hypothalamus, in the brain, and they were different. So that to me says that, you know, which we've talked about so many times, that it's, you know, it's not something that you choose, it's just who you are. I mean, I know that, I knew that myself when I was just a little kid. I was different, I didn't know why, I didn't even know what it was, but I knew that it was not a choice. And, you know, another thing too, I mean, I've never ever been sexually abused as a child, and I am gay. So, but I do know someone that was, actually by a Catholic priest. A good friend of mine was molested by a priest for quite a long time, but, we've talked about that before. We have discussed it. I've discussed this with my friend, and he said that even then he knew that he was gay before the priest even molested him. So the moral of the story is, you know, you are who you are, and you know, to deny yourself the opportunity to be with somebody physically and spiritually and mentally because of something that happened to you when you were a child, then that's not right either. It's not. You really need to seek help, because there is help out there for stuff like that. I think Michelle was talking about the thing that she saw on TV, the show about the woman that was kidnapped and sexually abused and for months, or maybe even years. I can't remember what she said, but in the end, you know, and after therapy, I'm sure she got married and had a family and fell in love and, you know, whatever. So it can happen, and I feel really bad for people that are like that. I do, because like I said, it never happened to me, and I'm glad that it never happened to me. But that had absolutely no influence on who I am today, my childhood. So I think, hope that answers the question for you. So that's about all really I have to say about that. We're supposed to get some more snow, I think, tomorrow. So the whole northeastern United States. So it should be interesting, because we are going to the Browns game on Sunday, and that is not fun, especially to watch them lose and freeze to death in a snowstorm. So anyway, guys, that's all. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.